Part 2. Azure Moon. Garland Moon. The Golden Deer's Plea. The Kingdom Army has reclaimed the Kingdom capital and plans to immediately begin restoring the country and its forces. But an unexpected request arrives from Claude, leader of the Lester Alliance. Dimitri promptly responds to the request for aid, and he rushes to prepare the kingdom's forces.
We have received a request for aid from the Alliance. They are being invaded by the Empire. We have only just taken back Ferdiad, and yet I am already asking all of you to move out once more. Please accept my apologies for that.
That's no problem at all. More importantly, how is the Alliance faring?
House Regan has rallied the Alliance Lords. They are facing the enemy with all the strength they can muster. We do not know how far that will get them. It seems the enemy's relentless attacks have forced them into a tough situation. Their defeat at Gronder severely weakened the Alliance. I imagine the Empire now intends to destroy them before they can recover.
To think they'd watch us chase their soldiers out of the Kingdom capital, then immediately go invade the Alliance. Their general is Lord Volkard von Arendelle. He serves as regent to the Emperor. He has presumably taken command after the Emperor was wounded in Gronder.
He is known for his shrewdness and excels not only in domestic affairs, but tactics as well. He is not an opponent we should take lightly. Lord Arendelle. I always suspected that Lord Arendelle was behind the tragedy 9 years ago. The timing of his departure from the kingdom, the fact that he abruptly stopped making donations. Too many factors made him suspect. If Lord Arendelle conspired with Cornelia, then what Cronje and the others said 5 years ago? Well, never mind that for now. The Alliance needs our help. What are your thoughts?
If we turn our back on the Alliance and then Deirdre falls, it will undoubtedly make our situation difficult further down the road. We would have enemies in two directions, in the Alliance to the northeast, and in the Empire to the south.
That is true. In that scenario, we would not be able to safely march our soldiers to Enbar.
I am terribly worried about Lady Rhea, but I believe we must save the Alliance first.
Oh, maybe if we do this, the Alliance will help us out in return. We could ask them to help us attack the Empire. You know, a sneak attack or something.
Annie, when did you become so devious?
What do you think, Professor?
Yes, I agree. I will admit that there is something to be gained for us as well, for when we eventually march south. But far more importantly, they need us. We cannot turn our backs on them. We will arrange to head out at once. Prepare yourselves, everyone.
Thank you so much.
Here you are again. I see. The flowers you helped to water are in bloom now. Have a look. Indeed. My sister was fond of this one in particular. It never came up. Dusker is a dead land. Its flowers were all trampled under the boots of soldiers. But seeing this blossom brings back memories. I do not know why I am telling you all of this. It surprises me as well. But if you are from Fodlan, you must know what became of the people of Dusker. The people who betrayed their allies from Fargus. The ones who were punished for regicide. The Dusker are shunned for their crimes, even now. It would be in your interest not to spend any more time around me than necessary. You may think little of it now, but your reputation will eventually suffer. But, to be completely candid, it pleases me to be able to speak with you like this. If you truly do not mind, I would be glad to receive more visits from you in the future.
Capital recaptured. I desire to call him Your Majesty rather than Your Highness. He would refuse my desire, rightfully pointing out that he has not as yet been crowned. However, the day this war is ended and the Church has placed the crown upon his head, then he will truly be our king, and I will call him Your Majesty at last. I must go hear the reports from our spies. There is something worrying me, and no, it can wait. I shall tell you more when our information is more concrete.
I thought there was a chance that Cornelia had captured Lady Rhea, but it seems that is not the case. Our next foe, Lord Arendelle, was once a pious adherent to the Saros Creed. His contributions to the Church stopped quite abruptly some time ago. I think it is likely the man knows something.
You plan to aid Claude, do you not? Huh. I think that is absolutely marvelous. Being opposing forces at the Battle of Gronder was ill-fated. It hurt to side against him. I am happy that things have taken a brighter turn now.
There is still more to learn.
Speaking of which,
well,
hello there.
Could be.
So House Regan has regained its influence in the Alliance and is gathering forces. Claude always was somewhat inscrutable. It's strange somehow to hear talk of his brilliance as the leader of the Alliance.
This experience is critical.
Looks like. I'm not sure if I ever knew.
Drew, huh? I've always wanted to go there. In Fargus, most of the towns are pretty much glorified fortresses. So, to hear about a place called the Aquatic Capital, it just sounds so elegant. When the war's over, I hope I can visit with everyone there.
I went to visit my adoptive father at his home in the capital. He used to grovel at Cornelia's feet when the city was under her control. But after it was liberated, he started courting the kingdom instead. Absolutely. He's hopeless. I suppose when you're a merchant, that's all you know. No matter what becomes of the world, it'll always be plagued by people like him.
That reminds me.
The very same night we liberated the capital, a messenger arrived from Daedru. Claude must have predicted that we'd retake it. Claude's a hard person to read. It's obvious not much escapes his eye, though. Kind of unsettling, honestly.
Dear Goddess, please allow His Majesty to rest in peace. Who is it? Oh, Professor. What brings you here at this hour? The hour is late, Professor. You should be resting in preparation for the day to come. I was offering my prayers to the Goddess. It is all that I can do now. I told you I was in service of the royal family, yes? When I was only a young soldier, the king saw fit to make a knight of me. I was given the great honor of guiding and protecting the royal family. It was similar to your own work. I was a teacher of sorts. I instructed both King Lambert and Prince Dimitri in the arts of combat, tactics, and academia. I also did all in my power to keep them safe. Until that day, I was unable to fulfill my duty. I was powerless. Yes. When I received word of the attack, it was already too late. His Majesty was dead, along with many knights and soldiers. If only I had made it to Dusker more quickly. After that, I abandoned my wife and child and fled my homeland. I turned my back on everything I swore to protect. My sins are countless. I will bear the weight of my guilt for as long as I live. Apologizing to my daughter and wife, devoting myself to His Highness. That is the way to atonement. And yet, even if I am granted the forgiveness of those who still live, praying is all I can do to atone to those who are with us no more. Long ago, there was someone who told me something quite similar. Forgive me. This will not do. As I grow older, I find myself talking endlessly about the past. But it is too late for such things now. I have finished my prayers. We should return.
I appreciate your efforts. This could be. Of course, I. Quite intrigued.
I must ask you. Ah, I see.
Come, there is much to do.
I am a little worried. We did well enough.
I'm just not there yet.
Some new insight.
I've learned a thing or two from battle.
Here's the result.
Thank you.
The skill will serve me well in the future.
I'm finally great.
We completed our task without incident. I understand.
Well worth the effort.
This'll help keep me alive.
Passed.